Let's install Ubuntu on our Windows PC so we can have them alongside each other. Let's start by heading to Google and find the Ubuntu ISO file. It can be found in the ubuntu.com website. Once the download starts, you can make a donation to several Ubuntu-related projects and also subscribe to the newsletter. The file is about 2.6 GB, so the download may take a while. Next thing is downloading a tool called Rufus, which we will use to create the installation media. It only weighs about 1 MB, so this one should be a quick download. Here is the Ubuntu ISO file we just downloaded on my desktop. Now plug in a flash drive to be used as the installation media. Now let's run Rufus from Windows Start menu. You'll probably be presented to a prompt screen requiring you to allow Rufus to make changes to the computer. Just click on Yes. Make sure that the device selected in the drop-down menu is the flash drive you want to use as the installation media. Its size may help you with that. Now choose the Ubuntu ISO file we downloaded. Leave the rest of the options with their default values, then click on Start. Rufus copies the ISO file to the flash drive and prepares it to be used as an installation media. You need to decide where you want Linux to reside. You can either allocate a portion of your hard drive or use a separate storage device, such as an external hard drive or another flash drive. If you want to install it on your hard drive, you're going to have to free up some space. To do that, we'll use the Disk Management utility, which is built into Windows. Here you can see the available partitions. We will have to shrink the C drive to allow Linux to be installed there. Notice that if you don't want to install Linux on your hard drive, you don't need the Disk Management tool at all. Right-click on C and select Shrink Volume. You now need to select by how much you want to shrink the disk space allocated to Windows. You should free up at least 10 GB in order to install Ubuntu Desktop. This might get tricky and you might not be able to free up as much disk space as you have available. Defragmenting the disk and reinstalling Windows may somewhat increase the available shrink. But as I am going to use a second flash drive to install Ubuntu on, I'm not going to bother with any of that, so I'm just going to cancel. Next thing is turning BitLocker off. Since we're soon going to remove Secure Boot, leaving BitLocker on may cause all kinds of nuisances. So let's forestall it by turning it off. Mine is already off, but if yours is on, turn it off. Turning it off starts a decryption procedure, and it takes a while. But you don't have to wait for it to finish. Just turn it off and you're good to go. Okay. Let's move on to restarting the computer. When the computer boots up, tap rapidly on the Escape key to load the boot menu. First, we need to enter Setup. Click F7 to switch to Advanced Mode. In the Boot tab, make sure that you have Fast Boot disabled and also CSM support disabled. In the Security tab, scroll to the bottom until you reach the Secure Boot option. Then make sure that Secure Boot Control is disabled. Then hit F10 to save and quit. Again, tap Escape rapidly to start the boot menu. Select the flash drive from the list, as this is the installation media. Ubuntu is checking the media integrity. It takes a few minutes. Now let's select Install Ubuntu. If you're installing Ubuntu to an external storage device, such as a second flash drive or an external hard drive, plug it in now. Then continue the installation. You can now connect to a Wi-Fi network. Then you need to choose the type of installation you want. The default is normal installation, but I'm going for the minimal installation, as I don't intend to use the additional software that comes with the normal installation. You should check the third-party option, as it may improve hardware support. In the installation type, we're going to choose something else. Linux recognizes two disks. One is the hard drive. That's the one with 256 GB. It's called SDA. The other option is the empty flash drive we just plugged in. That's the one with 61 GB, and it's called SDC. SDB, by the way, is the installation media itself, but it's not on the list. Now, the file system used by Linux is different than the one used by Windows, so we need to recreate the partitions on the flash drive. Let's select it from the list, then click on the minus sign to remove everything currently on it. SDC now only has one partition, which is free space. By the way, if we would shrink the Windows partition, we would see the free space on the hard drive right here. Currently it's zero because I didn't shrink it. But if you did and want to install Linux on your hard drive, do the following steps on the free space here, instead of the free space on the flash drive. Let's add the swap partition. Swap is disk space used by Linux when it's running out of RAM. It should be at least half the size of your RAM, but if you have the space, you could go all the way to the entire size of your RAM. Now, let's allocate the main partition for the Linux installation. It should be the remaining free space. Choose ext4 file system and /- as the mount point. That's it. Let's click on Install Now. The partitions that are about to be changed are listed. Since I don't want any changes to be made to my hard drive, I'm making sure that only SDC is about to be changed. Select your location. Type in your name, your computer's name, your username, and your password. When the installation is done, click on Restart Now. Remove the installation media. If you installed Ubuntu to a flash drive, like I did, make sure you remove the correct one. That is, remove the installation media. But the target flash drive, into which Linux was installed, should stay put. The computer is being restarted, and that's basically it. Whenever you want to start Linux, you'll have to rapidly tap F10 on Restart and select it from the boot menu. And if you want to log into Windows, just wait when restarting. One more thing. If you installed Linux on a removable storage device, such as a flash drive, you might see the following screen when you remove it and try to load Windows. If it happens, it means that Linux is set as the first priority on boot, which is not what we want. To change it, restart the computer again and enter Setup once more. Then in Boot Priority, on the right side of the screen, move Windows to the top of the list, then hit F10 to save the settings and exit. And that's it! Tap Escape to start Linux via the boot menu, or do nothing to start Windows. Thanks for watching.